We want to solve the differential equation dy dt equals 4 times the quantity y minus 6, and we're also given the initial condition y of 0 equals 2, so we'll be able to find the particular solution to this differential equation. We can solve this differential equation using separation of variables, meaning we can write this equation so we have a function of y times dy on the left and a function of t times dt on the right. To begin, let's multiply both sides of the equation by dt. So we would have dy equals 4 times the quantity y minus 6 times dt. And because we have dy on the left, we want this factor of y minus 6 on the left. So now we'll divide both sides by the quantity y minus 6. That would give us dy divided by the quantity y minus 6 equals 4 times dt. If we want, we can write this as 1 divided by the quantity y minus 6 dy equals 4 dt. And now in this form, we can integrate both sides of the equation. We'll integrate the left side with respect to y. We'll integrate the right side with respect to t. So the integral of 1 divided by the quantity y minus 6 is equal to natural log of the quantity y minus 6 plus c. So I'll write natural log. I'll include the absolute value here, but we'll see in a little bit while it's not necessary. And instead of putting plus c here, we'll combine the two constants of integration and put the constant only on the right. So this is going to be equal to the integral of 4 with respect to t would be 4t. And then we'll say plus c sub 1, again where c sub 1 combines the constant on the left and on the right. Now our goal here is to solve this for y, not natural log of the quantity y minus 6. So I think in the previous video, we wrote this log equation as an exponential equation, but we can also exponentiate both sides of the equation, meaning e raised to this quantity on the left must equal e to this quantity on the right. And notice how e raised to this power here is always going to be positive, and that's the reason why the quantity y minus 6 will always be positive. So on the left, this simplifies nicely to just y minus 6. And on the right, we have e raised to the power of 4t plus c sub 1. Because we have a sum in the exponent, we can write this as e to the power of 4t times e to the power of c sub 1. Well, e to the power of c sub 1 would just be another constant. So if we let a equal e to the power of c sub 1, we could write this as y minus 6 equals e to the power of 4t times a, or a e to the power of 4t. Now we'll go ahead and add 6 to both sides of the equation. So we would have y equals a times e to the power of 4t plus 6. So this would be the general solution to the differential equation, but now because we have the initial condition y of 0 equals 2, we can actually find the particular solution. If y of 0 equals 2, that means when t equals 0, y must equal 2. So by substituting 2 for y and 0 for t, we can find a, giving us the particular solution. So if we substitute 2 for y, we'd have 2 equals a times, if t is 0, this would be e to the 0, which is 1, plus 6. Subtracting 6 on both sides, notice how we would have a equals negative 4, which means the particular solution to this differential equation would be the function y of t equals a, which is negative 4, times e raised to the power of 4t plus 6. I hope you found this helpful.